Hi lads and lasses, Modest Pelican here with GTA Online. If you enjoyed this video, please take the cardboard signs away from homeless people on the street and replace it with ones that say subscribe to Modest Pelican Gaming, as this really helps spread the good word of my channel. Meet Vic Man, a retired assassin who is on a mission to become the most powerful crime lord in Los Santos, whilst also ensuring he stays sufficiently hydrated at all times. These are the boys, 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 and together they form a feared gang known as the Sons of Virgins. These are their stories.
Bruh.
So you might be thinking to yourself, Pelly, why are you out here trying to solve the world's greatest mystery? Why are you trying to answer the ancient myth of taking a taxi ride all the way to the top of Mount Chiliad? That sounds like a Sonny Evans video. Who do you think you are, Pelican, Sonny Evans? Well, no I don't, because that's the legend himself, Sonny Evans, right there, kicking my helicopter. Surprise, this is an ambitious anime crossover. We've barely been in each other's presence for more than a few moments, and we're already aggressively attacking each other. He gains the upper hand, but then my boy Stealthomato politely introduces himself by beating the man in cold blood with a wrench. Welcome to Xbox Live, Sonny, where the toxicity is far higher than our frame rates. Sonny and I have organized a violent taxi race between his crew, the Honeybees, and my crew, the Sons of Virgins. This is a manly event, worthy of a pre-game ritual, so of course we do the SOV special and all hop into a pool together wearing small yellow matching swim shorts. It's not weird, it's manly, because there's a woman over there cowering for her life. Before we get into the taxi royale, I best answer the great legend, which just so happens to be the title of this video. Let's go find ourselves a taxi. I order one, and I swear to God, if this is one of those fake taxis and he expects me to give him an over-the-pants handy or something instead of paying, I mean, sure I'll do it, I love an easy saving, but my heart's not going to be in it. He turns around and looks into my soul, asking where we're heading. I tell him to Heaven's Gates. Now, I probably should have taken this cab from the bottom of the mountain, not the city, but I guess this is more immersive. I really feel like I'm stuck behind a slow driver, but that RV do be looking thick. The dodgy Malacca then pulls into some farm and charges me $323 for the ride. I know I didn't stutter when I asked him to drive me to the summit, so I do what I have to do. I wonder if he had a wife and children. Actually, no, I hope he had a wife and children. Anyway, I expected something like this on our first attempt, but I'm not going to rest until one of these taxi drivers takes me to the very top. The key issues are that these men clearly don't want to do that. The second they get off the road, they lose their little useless NPC minds. I obviously don't want to keep paying for cab fares, so every failed attempt means I'm forced to murder another driver, which is quite emotionally taxing. Fortunately, my friend Jezzo has come to save the day in his cargo bob, and he'll scoop me up like pelicans scoop up hot biddies in their 40-50 cm large, elongated bills. Rockstar are one step ahead though, as the bob can't attach its hook to the taxi. I don't know why this is a feature, but it is. Trust me, we spent way too much time making 100% sure of this, but not nearly as much time as we spent on the next strategy. For some reason, Jezzo owns a Titan, which could be just the vehicle we need. It has a ramp, and if we can persuade a taxi driver to go into the back, magic could happen. It's quite sketchy once you're in the back, but if we can drop the taxi with me as a passenger onto the top of Mount Chiliad, technically he could drive the last portion. We find an efficient and safe method of forcing the cabs into the hold. This was fiddly, but once we had a method, it was okay. The next part was a motherfucking nightmare. This is my point of view. I just look at the back of this Indian man's head. I'm also not a part of this system, so I smoke inside his vehicle because smoking is cool and fun. The first variable is that the Titan blows up with no notice pretty regularly because the car is so glitchy. This usually leaves us halfway up Mount Chiliad with no parachute or vehicle, meaning we have to repetitively jump to our death. Most people only have to take their own life once. Imagine the hell we're going through right now. If we're lucky, the plane spontaneously combusts over the water and the driver and I drown together as the Titan's cabin becomes our watery tomb. Seriously, I question how this is a military aircraft, as if you look at it too hard, it explodes. The second variable is that the cab drivers scare easily, like they were bloody gazelles. I guess we are abducting them, but still, be an adult. The final, and by far the hardest variable, is the actual dropping of the taxis. Sometimes they come out fast, sometimes they come out slow, and once the door is open, Jezzo loses power to the plane. This makes orchestrating the drop highly problematic and requires all of our intelligence, which honestly isn't much. I do find it funny how the drivers seem completely unfazed by the events that are taking place. They do sometimes try and drive us up, but in reality we'll need an exceptionally clean drop. I think it goes without saying that I kill every man who fails us just like all good leaders should. I say bring back the death penalty for minor crimes. I'll show you some of our best attempts, but I am cutting out so many fails. The fails are kind of weird because it's just me in a dark cargo hold smelling an Indian man's hair, but I can't stress how many attempts we are taking. It was approximately 20 minutes between each drop, meaning we were averaging 3 an hour, which wasn't great. My favourite attempt was when I went into first person and smoked the entire way down Mount Chiliad like a boss. The smoking is great, you should start immediately. At literally 4 a.m, we decided to give it one last shot. One last chance to have our names written down in the GTA history books forever. The sun was out and it was a clear day, also known as the perfect condition to bomb some taxis.
Success isn't about how much money you make, it's about how many taxis you take to the top of Mount Chiliad.
Bruh.
It's an extremely successful drop, but my taxi is literally the dumbest person in the world and doesn't put the brakes on. We begin slipping and my heart sinks as we slide further and further down the hill and I see the dream falling through my fingers. All of a sudden, the big girl finds God and plants his foot on the brake, leaving us in a precarious position about 50 meters from the summit. At 4 in the morning, a normal person would call it a dubs. But Jezzo and I are no normal people. We are registered sex offenders, I legally have to tell you that every 3 months, but we are also epic gamers. What you're about to witness is 45 minutes worth of gameplay heavily edited as Jezzo grabbed my Deluxo and pushes the cab to the top of the hill manually. This was not only valiant, it was also implausible as these taxis seem to have the armor plating of a Panzer tank. The sun comes up like my serotonin never does, and at last we're here. We've done it. This is one of my greatest achievements, which I think says a lot about me as a person. The cabbie driver runs away as I salute the legend who did basically nothing. I guess I also did nothing, I just sat there in the back of the cab. In fact, Jezzo did absolutely everything, so thanks for the carry, bro. It's my Call of Duty videos all over again, which I post on my second channel, Papa Pelly, shameless plug. We celebrate by applying a generous amount of machete onto the surrounding hikers. Bloody hikers, man, always think they're better than everyone because they own a Kathmandu jacket and are asexual. It's now time for the main event. It's time to battle Sonny Evans and his boys GTA Man and Dr. Buttkiss PhD, which is a pretty gangster game attack. I'll be joined by Stealtho Mato and Stealtho Fielder. The rules are simple. 3 rounds where each person has to catch a cab from A to B and the first one there wins. The other two players can use their vehicles to affect the cab trip any way they choose. To be honest, the rules are pretty vague, just like my uncle's perception of consent. Sonny and I will be in the taxi first, and seriously, what is with these guys undressing me with their eyes? The red tie and tailored suit both stay on, big fella. We're off, and the lads assume they're blocking positions. This is gameplay in its finest form. This makes the Grand Prix look like a Hot Wheels track. The atmosphere is tense, and Dr. Buttkiss PhD has chosen a cement mixer, which was a high-risk, high-reward choice of vehicle. You don't get a PhD in eating ass by playing it safe, that's for damn sure. There is a slight tactical communication and the road opens up as I manage to fly away freely. We get the dubs, but this was just a practice round. Dr. Buttkiss PhD takes the preseason loss pretty well. The first real round doesn't start with a bang. I sure do respect a white van as much as the next seedy Caucasian guy called Jeff, but I'm not sure if it is the optimum choice of vehicle for this race. Needless to say, the honeybees take round one. I take the loss well, as it's important to be professional and show good sportsmanship. These lads sure did come to play today, so we decide to reach deep into our bag of tricks and bamboozle them with some mopeds. They accept the terms and round two begins. You're allowed to kick other players off their bikes, but strictly no weapons. The trick with a moped is to recognize it's not as powerful as a car. It's best to use its mobility and swiftness to redirect traffic rather than using its brute force. This is what I call the core concept of a motorcycle. Things are going pretty well for us, and then Dr. Buttkiss kicks me and kills me. That was no kick though, that was a knife. Despite this suspicious incident, the boys hang on and get the dubs. I knew I could count on them. Sonny and I both opt for gigantic trucks, which just shows that YouTubers really do have below average sized peenies. It's a nightmare start as Stealtho Mato is immediately turned around by a stunning pit maneuver performed by GTA Man. This sets up a dream run for our opposition, but right at the finish line, I managed to stop the good doctor in his tracks. Literally inches from the finish line, with the tensions high, I hear that Mato has rolled his cab and killed the driver. All hope is lost. Then, like an angel, he descends down the exit ramp and arrives at the destination first, but it was via a van he drove himself. That doesn't seem fair, but we take the easy dubs. I'm kidding, and then everyone dies in a huge gas explosion, and we decide the only fair way to settle this is a fist fight to the death. Stealtho Fieldo haymakers Sunny in the head for drinking a soda, and then we get down to business. The top of Maze Bank Tower. Heroes are made here, and helicopters also land here. That was a pretty poor follow-up to the initial heroes thing, but whatever. The fight begins, and the atmosphere is heated. I hate these malakas with all my heart, and I want to see them all burn alive. I'm kidding, they're lovely guys, we actually all got on really well, and we'll definitely play together again. Sunny takes down Stealtho Fieldo, and then I take down Sunny, and for a brief moment, I think we've won. Then GTA Man kills me. GG to the honeybees, they fought extremely well. Stealtho Fieldo then asks how everyone was dodging his punches. The man didn't know how to dodge. He doesn't play much, but still, we all went down swinging, and the important thing is that everyone had fun. I'm kidding, we lost, and I'll be thinking about this every night for the next 6 months, and eventually end up blaming lag, because self-accountability is for nerds. A huge shout out to Sunny Evans for organising all of this. I'll link his channel below, he creates some incredibly high quality content. Thanks for watching, you absolute legends, and a massive thanks to those who support the channel on Patreon. Until next time, and as always, stay classy.